When you have a good breastfeeding latch, then that means that your nipple is deep in your baby's mouth and off center, so it's pointed up toward the roof of your baby's mouth. This is when you'll feel just a pulling, tugging tenderness sensation. If it's ever pinchy painful, that means that something needs to change. So a good latch also means that when your baby comes off, then your nipple should still be round, exactly how it looked before it went into your baby's mouth. Now, what would you do if it's been feeling that pinchy painful and your nipple comes out looking kind of mashed like that and like compressed, like it has a creased line? Like if you were to fold a paper and then do a strong crease on it, that's what your nipple looks like. If this is the situation, that means that your baby started out aimed directly at the center of your nipple and latched on centered, and then is kind of chomping on your nipple between their top and bottom gums. Not only is this a pinchy, painful feeling for you, but it also means a poor feeding for your baby. So this means that every press is closing off those tubes of the milk ducts, and every release has to be harder and stronger to get any milk out. And it also looks like at the corner of your baby's mouth, it's narrow, like slurping spaghetti. So this is not the best situation that you want to be in. So to make it better, then you would have your thumb on top like this, because your fingers would be on the bottom and your thumb on top. So you're going to compress and wedge your breast a little bit more like this. And you're going to aim your nipple at your baby's nose so their mouth is aimed on your areola, not directly at their nipple. So you can think about it either as waiting until your baby opens their mouth really wide, and then you land their chin and just roll them on top of your nipple, so your nipple's pointing up to the roof of their mouth. Or you can think about it as opening wide and you just flip or tuck your nipple into the top of their mouth. Either way, you want your baby's gums to land deep on your breast so you can see just a crescent of areola at their upper lip and by their nose, or none at all. And below your baby's chin, you want to see little to no areola. So it's off center to your areola, meaning that your nipple is deep there. Now, what do you do if your nipple comes out looking wedged like a new tube of lipstick? So that happens because your baby started out kind of shallow and centered at your nipple. And then as you scooped your baby on, instead of going straight forward like this, your baby went high and kind of like hooked up and around. So that means that their gums are scraping the bottom of your nipple here, mashing your nipple up that direction. So again, still shallow and narrow like slurping spaghetti, and a little more pinched right at the front of their hard palate. So it feels like a pinchy, painful, like a curl your toes kind of cringe. Immediately take your baby off by putting your finger to the corner of their mouth, breaking the suction by pulling toward their cheek, taking them off, and retrying as many times as it takes to get to that pulling, tugging tenderness. Again, that's aiming low. Let me get a baby doll to show you this as well. It's aiming with the nose to nipple and compressing your breast like a tall hamburger, waiting for their mouth to open wide, and then landing the chin and then rolling into the top of their mouth. So they land with chin buried into the breast, their chin is lifted off their chest, nose is gently touching, cheeks are gently touching, and you see areola above their upper lip, and it just feels like pulling, tugging pressure. Now, if all of your techniques to make changes are causing the same pain and nothing is changing, then I encourage you to look up your breastfeeding resources, call a lactation consultant, and make an appointment to get some help. That person can help you with adjusting the position of your baby, showing you exactly how to fix it, and identifying other ways to get that latch better for you. So you never have to sit home and struggle. There's always an answer for you. Intermountain has many outpatient resources, so I encourage you to find that breastfeeding resource list to get some hands-on help.